Okay, Dave, looking at what they call Crowfoot fittings. They're also called Chicago fittings. I think it depends on where you're from is what you call it. I'm not sure, but in this part of the country, we definitely call them Crowfoot. And you can look at it and see that it's two positions on each fittings. Now, there's three basic types of Crowfoot, and one of them is a female thread, the other one is a male, and the third is a barb. In order to put them together, you have to line them up, line up the legs, the feet that come out on the crow feet, and push it into place. And they're kind of, you have to get it lined up. Then it's compressed and twisted together, and that puts pressure on both of the gaskets. Now this is what the gasket looks like. It goes in them. It's ridged so that it can catch inside of the lip that someone was out of gasket. And like I say, they're very hard to put together unless you've got them hooked up. If you've got one of them screwed into a fitting on a pump or on a compressor, and one of them is put on there normally, which putting the hose to the compressor, so you have your hose already mounted on this barbed end, and then turn around and put it in, lock together. A lot easier when they're hooked up to the parts they go with. So we have them in 3/4 inch, which is what these are. We also carry them in a 2 inch. The 2 inch, that's two 2 inch males hooked together. Kind of shows you they do hook together. Again, there's the male and there's the female in a 2 inch. As you can see on most, on all of the videos, the male and the female here, male and female, they hook on to their hose here, but they just screw on to a pipe fitting. NPT, they're all NPT threads. Screws onto the pipe fitting, locked it in place. On this one, you slide a hose up on it with clamps, and you clamp the hose onto it, and the hose can be a foot, it can be 50 foot, it can be 300 feet, it doesn't matter. The end cooks up on here and locks down. I'm going to reach down here and pull a hose to show you basically what a hose looks like with a fitting on it. I don't know if you can see that through the material or not, but there's your fitting, and it's a barb fitting. It goes down to about here, and then the clamps are put on it. These happen to be center punch clamps. They can be any type of hose clamp will work, but these hold up the pressure real well. And that's a 50 foot hose. You can use them. They're mainly used to hook up to company factory air or an air compressor, a large air compressor, 185 CFM cubic feet per minute to 325 cubic feet per minute. And they hook on them, they'll run them out in the field, hook them to a piece of equipment like a jackhammer. Some of the big hammers use, but almost all of them use just 3/4 size. When you need some high pressure air, you're transferring from one plant to another, or from one stage of the plant to another. Sometimes they'll go back and use a 2 inch to get the larger volume of air. One thing back onto the, I think I said this a while ago, but when you lock these together and you look, there'll be holes in the sides. They line up with each other. So you can take an R-clip, push it through, and it prevents the hose from twisting them loose and popping off. Use these on, normally, compressors are putting out 100 to 150 PSI. These are good for that. But when you start to get into high pressure, the rubber gasket is not going to hold. So anything up to the 200 and 300 range, up into the thousands of PSI, you have to have a totally different type of fitting. These are for quick connecting to get an air hose hooked up to a compressor fast and stretch it out and go ahead and run it. It's easy to take off and roll back up. All high pressure stuff is threaded on. So you can't really, you have to unscrew it every time you take it off. So it's just made for convenience and speed. So action hose and fittings. Just come by and see us and we'll help you out.